My name is Elizabeth Ross, and welcome to the overview video for Unit 5, Remembering, Accessing Working Memory. The brain's ability to process, manipulate, and store information is critical to a student's ability to learn. When students don't know how to access information efficiently, it can leave them feeling lost and confused. For example, when asked how they study for an important test, many students will report that they just read the material over and over again until it sticks. While rote repetition may work in some cases, it does not reflect a strategic approach to remembering. It takes too much time and energy, and it will become increasingly difficult for these students to manage large amounts of material in their classes as they advance through the grades. The lessons in this unit will help your students learn how memory works and how to apply this knowledge to their academic work. They will come to understand the three components of memory. They will explore their own memory strengths and weaknesses, and they will learn a number of remembering strategies that they can use to recall important information. First, let's look at the three components of memory. The three types of memory include short-term memory, long-term memory, and working memory. Short-term and long-term memory are familiar to most people. Information received from the five senses is stored in short-term memory. It is retained for a short period of time before the information is either placed in long-term memory or forgotten. Your friend tells you her new cell phone number, and you repeat it in your head until you write it down. This is an example of short-term memory. Long-term memory, on the other hand, is the storage house in the brain, storing information for a longer period of time. Remembering the words to the Pledge of Allegiance is an example of information stored in long-term memory. Both long-term and short-term memory are crucial to successful learning. However, the role of working memory is often overlooked. What is working memory? Working memory is the ability to hold information in one's mind and to mentally manipulate this information. Working memory draws on both short-term and long-term memory and holds the information for a short time during tasks. Students' working memory is crucial to the learning process because it allows them to take in new information and synthesize it with previous knowledge. Taking notes during a lecture or solving a word problem in math are dependent on working memory. A student with a weakness in working memory may struggle to show what they know. They may not perform well on tests because they cannot access and manipulate information easily. In addition, they often work slowly to complete day-to-day tasks. As a result, these students often become frustrated, thinking that they are bad at math or history. They often give up rather than rethinking their approach. This is why teaching students about their memory is a crucial first step. After learning about the components of memory and how they function, it's time to develop a strategic approach to remembering that will allow students to study more efficiently and retain more information. Two lessons in this unit deal with mnemonics, devices that serve as memory aids. Mnemonics, such as using Roy G. Biv to remember the colors in a rainbow, have been proven to successfully improve a student's ability to remember and retain information. They can help a student remember facts or vocabulary words, as well as more complex information, such as a series of steps that must be done in order. SMARTS introduces students to a range of mnemonic devices, from cartoons and associations to crazy phrases and stories. With remembering strategies, students can go beyond simple rote memorization. They will discover that simply rereading information is not the only way to memorize it. When students have a chance to practice each type of mnemonic, they can begin integrating them into their study materials, transforming their approach to studying, saving time, and improving their performance. As you learn about effective remembering strategies with your students, keep in mind the following principles. Apply strategies flexibly. Different remembering strategies are more appropriate for certain types of information. Cartoons and associations are great for challenging vocabulary, but crazy phrases and stories are better for remembering multi-step processes. Encourage students to select the appropriate strategy for the information they're trying to remember. Think beyond studying. Remembering strategies are not only for studying for a test. You can create remembering strategies to help students organize their belongings. See the 4Cs strategy in Unit 4, Lesson 1. Or develop effective goals. See the can-do strategy in Unit 2, Lesson 1. Make it personal. While we can probably all remember certain mnemonics by heart, mnemonics work best when based on previous experience or knowledge. Therefore, personalized, unique mnemonics created by students are the most effective. Quick tip! If a student has a favorite hobby or interest, suggest that they reference it when creating mnemonics. This will establish a positive connection to the mnemonic device, making it easier to remember. Thanks for watching the overview video for Unit 5. Keep these concepts in mind as you teach the SMARTS remembering lesson plans. Please refer back to this video whenever necessary. And if you have any further questions, comments, or concerns, please contact us at info@researchild.org.